Welcome to Sairam Educational Channel. In this video, we will see some more important questions and solutions from the lesson Aldehydes, Ketones and Carboxylic Acids, Class 12, NCERT. Surely there is one question comes this type where you need to identify the particular compound. It can be a 5-mark question or 3-mark questions based on the type of question. And here the scheme will be marking scheme. If you identify simply, you will not get. You need also to write the equations and identify if they give several compounds. But here they asked only one compound. You can see this problem. Organic compound with molecular formula C5H10O. It does not reduce tolerance reagent. So we should start with there one by one clues what we know. For example, solution. Molecular formula was given C5H10O. It is oxygen containing compound and it does not reduce tolerance reagent. Tolerance reagent is a weak reagent. If it is not reducing, that means it is not aldehyde. Clear? So the aldehydes will reduce tolerance reagent and Pahlink's reagents. And in the tolerance reagent, it will give a silver mirror, that is silver. It forms Ag2O, you can consider as tolerance reagent, simplest form. Otherwise, it is ammonical silver nitrate solution. So it will convert into silver when it reacts with the aldehydes. That means it is not giving the tolerance reagent test. That means it is not aldehyde. Clear? So no aldehyde. It is not aldehyde. We will write simply to understand, to rule out the possibilities. Then the second one, it forms addition compound with sodium hydrogen sulfide. All aldehydes, ketones forms addition compounds with sodium hydrogen sulfide, hydrazine, hydroxylamine. These are the addition compounds generally. That means it is forming addition compound. That means it could be any carbonyl, it is having a carbonyl group. Now in the carbonyl you have two, one is aldehydes, another is ketones. So it could be a ketone then. Because we told here it is not aldehyde, but it is a carbonyl group because it is participating addition reaction with sodium hydrogen sulfide. So it can be a ketone. And it also gives positive iodoform test. The iodoform test generally gives secondary alcohols or carbonyl compounds with CH3 group. We need to remember these things. CH3 C double bond O group. For example, this is a carbonyl compound. If I have CH3 CO group, whether it is aldehyde or ketone, if it is H, it is acetaldehyde. It can be aldehyde or ketone, whatever it is. If it is having this methyl group, CH3 CO, then it gives iodoform test. So it can be ketone containing CH3. Up to here we could come now because of this iodoform test. But on vigorous oxidation, if this ketone containing this particular structure, now you need to identify this. What is this? Correct? Because it is iodoform CH3CO you identified, and previously carbonyl group, it is ketone because not aldehyde, it is not reacting with tolerance reagent. So we need to identify what could be here. So the last one gives you clue. On vigorous oxidation, upon oxidation, generally remember all carbonyl compounds upon oxidation gives carboxylic acids. Aldehydes give same number containing carboxylic acid. Ketones will give two different carboxylic acids. You see here, on vigorous oxidation, it given ethanoic acid and propanoic acid. That means two different acids. That also tells it is a ketone. And how I should get ethanoic acid is what? CH3COOH, two carbon containing, that is acetic acid. Propanoic acid is three carbon containing, CH3CH2COOH. That means if I have an aldehyde, one side I can have two carbon containing, another side I can have three carbons. Total I have five. So that's why it is a ketone. One side is methyl, methyl CO, together you will get ethanoic acid. And if it breaks here, this particular alkyl group could be a propyl group. So this is the compound, because when I break here, this gives this particular acid, propanoic acid, this gives ethanoic acid. So using this, we can able to identify this particular compound. Here it was given just for 3 marks, so you need to explain like this and write the compound, then it is sufficient. They have not asked for the reactions. So you have CH3CO. So this is ethanoic acid and propanoic acid. You see, since we know it is a propanoic acid, you are writing here a straight chain. If you doesn't know this propanoic acid, then what options we can find out? C double bond O. Here I can write like this also. This is isopropyl group. But since it is giving propanoic acid, the breakage is here, then this last one will become COOH. So it is, you can write normal propyl group. So methyl propyl ketone. This is the particular solution for this problem. The second question we will see. The second question was given here. 2 moles of organic compound A, 2 moles, on treatment with strong base like sodium hydroxide KOH gives B and C. 2 moles of A reacting with base given B and C. Compound B on dehydration with copper gives A. Compound B, if I do go for a dehydration, you will get A once again. While acidification of C, that compound C formed in the previous, yields carboxylic acid. This, if you take the C and acidify it, add acid, then you will get a carboxylic acid. That carboxylic acid's molecular formula was given, CH2O2. Using this, they asked to identify all the compounds, A, B, C, D. For this question, it is better to start with D itself, because the molecular formula was given for D. And they told it is a carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid with one carbon is COOH. This should be hydrogen. This is the simplest carboxylic acid. And it has 2 hydrogens, 2 oxygens and 1 carbon. That means it is formic acid. If D is formic acid, come to the back side. How the D was obtained? By acidification of C. So if I take C and acidify it, so when I will get acidification, that means it's salt if it is there. If you acidify, you will get acid. So that should be HCOONA like. This is the salt of this formic acid. Now you add H, then H will be replaced and it becomes formic acid. Correct? So sodium formate could be the your C. Because on acidification you got this. Done. Now, compound B on dehydration with copper gives A. So this is sodium formate, then H formic acid. Then what will be the 2 moles of A? So 2 moles of A given B and C. C you know now. So that means it can be like carbon, 1 carbon containing compound this. So 1 carbon containing compound, it can be like formaldehyde. Why it is formaldehyde? If I have 2 moles of formaldehyde, when reacts with strong, like NaOH, what will happen? This is a Cannizzaro reaction. 1 mole will oxidize, 1 mole will reduce. So I will be getting 1 mole oxidized, 1 mole is reduced. Reduced means I will get methyl alcohol, CH3OH, 1 mole containing alcohol. Aldehydes, ketones, when they reduce, they will give alcohols. When they oxidize, they will give carboxylic acid. So now this, I will get formic acid. But formic acid is with NaOH, so you will get a sodium formate. So the next compound is sodium formate, HCOONa, Na plus minus. So this is my A compound, then this will be B, this is C. Now you can try to re-understand this, then it will be done. You see here first the A, 2 moles of A, 2 moles of A, on treatment with strong NaOH base, it given B and C, one is methyl alcohol, another is sodium formate. Compound B on dehydration with copper gives A, whether it is correct or not, you will check. You take CH3OH and you dehydrate with copper, then H and H will go, then whatever left is HCHO. That means you are getting A once again back. So gives A. While acidification of C, C you add acid, you will get formic acid. That is the formula. So this way we can able to answer this particular question. Third question we will see now. You see this question, third one, written in on the board. Can you just see that? An aromatic an organic compound A, which has a characteristic odor, which has a specific odor smell, on treatment with NaOH forms two compounds, that is B and C, two compounds formed. A is having a specific smell, on treatment with NaOH it has given B and C. The molecular formula of B was given C7H8O, and B upon oxidation with chromium oxide CrO3, it given back A. C is a sodium salt of the acid. These are the clues given. C is the sodium salt of the acid. C upon heated with soda lime, it given a aromatic compound, aromatic hydrocarbon. Now they ask to identify all the compounds A, B, C, D. Here you see the, like a previous case, you can get a clue from the NaOH and two compounds. A should be something aldehyde, because upon treatment with NaOH, like Kanigher reaction, you will get B and C. And you have another clue is C is the sodium salt of the acid. That means in Kanigher reaction, one will you get the salt. If C is the sodium salt of the acid, then B should be, as per the Kanigher reaction, the aldehyde will get oxidized and reduced. That means B should be an alkal. You will have B should be like alkal. And B upon oxidation given A, then only it can give A, because alkals oxidize gives aldehydes. Aldehydes will reduce to give alkals. So B could be an alkal. That is clear now. A is aldehyde. Correct? A is aldehyde, B is alkal. That's what we have claimed. C anyhow, acid salt. D, you see, after C heating, you get a D which is aromatic hydrocarbon. That means now everywhere you can have aromatic group. So now we will try to write B first. How we can write? Because they have given molecular formula. Aromatic, I should have first benzene ring. So this is C6H6. If I have substituent C6H5. If you remove C6H5, how many carbons left? Even one carbon, C7. H will be three more are there, because 5 over. H3 and 1O. How I can write? H3 1O, and it is alkyl, so we can write like this, benzoyl alkyl. Clear? So such way we can observe it, we can able to find out. See, since the things are aldehyde and alkyl, and this is aromatic, so aromatic ring, that is C6H5. If I have a substituent, because I should have one carbon added, hydrogens three more left, three hydrogens on oxygen. So B is now benzoyl alkyl. If B is benzoyl alkyl, upon oxidation I will get what? Benzaldehyde. CHO. That means A will be my benzaldehyde. When A is benzaldehyde, A reacts with NaOH, that is Kanigher reaction, what we will get? One is benzoyl alkyl reduction, plus another one is sodium salt of benzoic acid. So the C will be a sodium salt of benzoic acid. It is benzene and COONa minus plus. That is sodium salt of benzoic acid, sodium benzoate. That is the C. Now the C upon treatment with soda lime, that is NaOH and CaO. Now I will rub here and I will write here. This sodium benzoate, that is C, that is COONa, upon treatment with NaOH and CaO, this is soda lime. When you NaOH, CaO, Na to CO3 will go, and H will add, then you will get a aromatic hydrocarbon, that is your benzene plus Na2CO3. Correct? Na2CO3 will go, H will add, that is called benzene Na2CO3. Now you can see from the starting A, benzaldehyde will have a specific order. Alkyl containing aldehydes may not have. Aromatic aldehydes will have the specific order, smell. So benzaldehyde has a specific order, and when treated with NaOH you get sodium benzoate is the C, and this is benzyl alcohol, CH2OH, that is benzyl alcohol. CH2OH, benzyl alcohol, that is the B. C is sodium benzoate. B on oxidation gives once again aldehyde, alcohol's oxidation gives aldehyde, that is benzaldehyde, once again you will get. C is sodium salt, of that we written. C upon treatment with soda lime you will get a D, that is aromatic hydrocarbon, that is benzene. Such a simplest way one can able to think. We can take the clue from anywhere in this. So we started with B because C7H8O, and it is a molecular formula given, and B and C, C we know it is acid, salt. So if C is acid, both are formed, B can be. We can guess by using our Kanajor reaction. Such way we can able to solve. I hope you understood these three questions. We will see in the next video some more. Thank you. Please do subscribe the channel for more updates.